to the plant message for this new lunar cycle. I hope you're doing well. It's nice to be here again in this podcast space that we have here. Feels to me like this growing lush garden where we circle up with the plant realm and receive guidance for the coming time. This lunar cycle coming up feels like a big one. One of the markers for me is that the plant spirit of Angelica, or Angelica root, wants to share a message. Their presence feels like a large, powerful, radiant presence to me, like a big light with stable grounding. And I noticed that my human self had to give a lot of way for this message to let this big energy flow through. Angelica was one of the first conscious connections I experienced with the plant early in my herbalist studies. I was drawn to them, and they were also abundant in my garden at the time for years. So they always stayed present with me, silently by my side. So I guess very much like an angelic presence, a nature angel, never in the forefront. But now they do step forward to speak. So I asked them why and why now. And here's what they replied. It seems always darkest before dawn. You know, there are countless ways how we can deal with our darkness. But one of the collective energies right now is to not face it, but settle for a compromised life, compromised dreams, relationships. Not seeing a way to more and therefore giving up a bigger life. And what Angelica shows is that this can take place outside our daily awareness, that apparently things seem to go their way, but with an unease in our underworld. So this plant consciousness appears here to cast a bright light where we may not be holding our own torch right now, and to wake us up by shining their light on the forgotten inner strength that we have and our absolute ability to move the seemingly unmovable. And believe me, they don't bring this lightly. They don't hold the energy of a pep talk. They bring this message in the light of the tough challenges that many people go through. They see people have to move beyond what they never have dared to go beyond. And at the same time, as I said, they also speak to those of us who are on the other end of the spectrum, where nothing urgently seems to be going on, but in a flat kind of way. You may know this experience of how unnoticeably you can fall asleep in your life. You forget how vital life feels, the energy of true freedom or deep intimacy, expansion or unconditional laughter, playfulness, giving a powerful yes or no to life. And when such liveliness does break through again, you wonder how you could have ever forgotten that feeling, that place within yourself, that life can be so much more than what you actually settled for. So intense challenges or flat living or any composition of those, we fall asleep while we live. And Angelica's here with a wake-up call to remind us of our inner strength with which we can face anything that our life presents us with, and to not give up. In fact, to raise what you want out of life for yourself and for others. So let's move on to the message and notice, as you listen, what wakes up in your awareness. This is Angelica. I'm here to help you digest the roots of fear. Fear that you are separate from all that is enriching in life. Fear consciousness blocks the digestion, but your ability to digest is the very thing that helps you break down angst, worries, and suffering, so that the sun behind these clouds can shine through again. Increased life force flows through again. Are you experiencing something that is difficult to go through? Is there an area, a quality of life, in which you find it difficult to move? I help you find and observe the fear roots in your existence. That by seeing them, knowing them, organically show the way to living from non-fear, so from love and freedom. Do you know your fears? Every suffering ultimately can be traced back to this. So what's the importance of examining your fears? Well, there's much life to experience beyond fear. Fear still has a large grip on humanity and drives life choices. It keeps humans contained, as an electric fence does. And so life feels limited because of it. When you choose to act from your heart wherever you can, so making choices that feel expansive and liberating, you adopt a diet that will consume your fears. Fear feeds fear, but nothing nourishes a more fertile soil or gut than your inner light, your heart quality. You have forgotten how much more powerful your inner light is than any threatening shadow. It's a stark contrast. See what I see, and you will dare to look any fear in the face, which is the same as pulling their root out of your experience. Humanity as a whole is digesting large amount of postponed fear experiences at this time. So experiences that at a certain moment in the past were too much or too big and were encapsulated and stored for a later moment. The digestive system, the gut, is a large repository for this. Now layers of fear are coming out of storage to the surface of your awareness. Know that this is a big reason why you came here in this life, descending into a body, into the human experiences. To break free from fear and embody an inner state of freedom. Accepting and giving expression to your inner strength is your destiny. And every step you take in this is a light for someone else. Where fear has been instilled, you can see that paralysis has occurred, which has been the breeding ground for victimhood and powerlessness, the disillusion of free will and choice. If you feel somewhere that leadership over your life has become passive, then it is important to now stay with the experience of, for example, the discomfort and the dissatisfaction about this. Taking responsibility for the truth of your moment, honesty with the moment, committing to not leave your now, is the first step to living your inner strength. These are indicators that you are pulling out of your now, giving up your presence. When the tendency arises to procrastinate things, when your ability to stay focused feels limited and you keep scattering your attention, when you check out internally in a situation, no longer really listening, waiting for something to pass, waiting for a better moment, still being occupied with what has already happened or being occupied with what has yet to come. The moment, the now, is the only place where transformation happens, in fact, where life happens. So not being present, for me, equals sleep mode. Living requires your presence. In the now, your life will always present you with exactly the information needed for the next step in your evolution in consciousness. So it will also try to make you aware of unconscious fear patterns that are no longer sustainable. There's often resistance to facing this and can therefore be preceded by irritation, boredom, fatigue, overactivity, addiction, hopelessness, depressions. This is the electric fence feeling, but know now that this is okay. You are simply evolving. See these as signposts, a call from your bigger you to you, wake up, look here, increase your presence. And if you do, it will activate your digestive capacity to transmute these states. So if presence is so important, let's look for a moment at what absence is. You are a consciousness living in a body, and as an energetical being, you experience everything through the physical senses. And with intense experiences, you can pull your energy up and out of the body to dampen the sensation. This is an intelligent function for emergencies, but not a sustainable way to live because it also dampens the circulation of your life force. Postponed experiences are waiting for your presence. Note, not reliving, but being present with. Root yourself in the earth. Choose by intention as much as you can to stay in your body, to keep breathing, and to stay in touch with your senses, really listening, really seeing, feeling, smelling, tasting, both your inner and outer world. Your being present with is shining your light on, and it's a superpower. A second step is to observe the fears that lie beneath the wanting out of the moment. These are areas where safety and choice feels limited. Give yourself permission to write down, I am afraid of, I'm afraid that, and see what comes up. You may also feel how far these fears go back in time. Allow these fears expression. You can see it this way. You cannot embody inner leadership if you do not recognize the landscape of powerlessness. By knowing the shadow, you find the light. This is how you can use polarity and be empowered by it. Use shadow feelings as an information board. Read it. Get to know the map of it within yourself, and you will see that the ability will rise to flip the board, so to read and follow the opposite story. This is a good news story. Shadow never exists without light, so let shadow point you to your light. This is how you digest, how you clear the clouds. Regain your shining vital life force, your creativity, lost soul parts, lost inner children. And finally, keep reminding yourself that you are not your experiences. Look at my body. My roots are your life rooted in the earth, which is a simulation reality where a separation exists. But every night you make your way back to the stars, to your bigger self. I mirror your big starlight in my flowers. There you know that you are already everything you ever wanted to be. This is all about remembrance. In the night you remember your greatness. The bigger picture, you gain insights, gather wisdom, and every morning you descend back to the earth, into the simulation of forgetfulness, But you do wake up with more awareness, with more inner guidance, and you step into your day with this stardust on your shoulders. In the plant session, I will show you how you can work with this. Be conscious of this connection with your inner guidance. See what lights up in your days that cracks limitations. Digesting shadow experiences activates your star seed on Earth, unlocks the gifts that you came to bring to life here. Don't underestimate the impact of your light on the bigger whole. Keep your head up when you walk and feel how tall you are, gracefully swinging your arms next to you like resting wings. And feel how deep your roots can reach into the earth. This way we can look each other in the face and wink. Heaven is here on earth. That was beautiful. I'm very grateful for Angelica to step forward, shine their light. And I hope as you listened that you regained a bit of your inner strength. If you want to do your own ceremony with Angelica, for example, this full moon, check out the information below about the plant session. This is a medicine journey with Angelica, and it's very powerful and healing. Right. Thank you for being here, and we will meet in the next episode.